What up, my fellow Monarch Monstars? You know what time it is. We got our brand new episode of Monarch Legacy of Monsters, episode 6. We're at the halfway point now, kicking off the second half. I'm excited. I've Apple TV has already hinted at what's coming up in this particular episode. I'm a little disappointed in them because I think they've revealed too much. But I think they did it for a reason. I think a lot of complaints have been happening lately. And, you know, the producers have kind of talked about, you know, there's never enough Godzilla, you know, even in their eyes. So something tells me we're probably going to get a lot of Gojira out there today for this episode 6. Terrifying Miracles is what this is going to be called. So, guys, if you haven't already, start queuing it up on your Apple TV. Get it ready, because we're going to watch along together. As you already know, because it's a watch party, I can't show the episode. For those who don't know what a watch party is, I can't show the episode on our YouTube channel. They'll take it down. You have to have Apple TV. You can do a 7-day subscription for free to check it out. So cue it up. This is your time to do it now. And let's see everyone who's in the chat real quick before we bring in some of our guests. We got Restore the Sniper's Guy, Bat Fanatic, Dean Classified, what's up, Atomic Kaiju 1954, Akio Lee, how's it going? Super Bro may appear, who knows? Wayne Enterprise, maybe a certain other person will appear as well. King Donkey Kong, Kaiju Crazy Craig Roland, we got Oracle's Clock Tower, Red Hooded Outlaw, Beyond the Night, what's up? How's it going, Battalion? You already know, big fella. You already know. I'm so excited for this new episode of Monarch. I'm really digging the show. Even though last episode was super controversial, I know. I thought it was a good character development episode. The Butler, the Batman Who Laughs, 9 Lives in Hell here. Good to see you, Mistress of Mayhem, Joker's Wild, my boy Trevor H coming in hot. And we also got Eric Patterson showing up. Guys, it is so good to see the Battalion family ready to go with Monarch Episode 6. Let's get through all the pleasantries real quick with our show. As you already know, you can follow us on our social media pages like Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, @_BatChannel. Or if you're on Facebook, @HolyBatChannel. It's a great way to get in touch with us. DM us, talk about some of the cool things that are going on in the Battalion community or what's going on in your life. Maybe you see something in the entertainment world and you're like, bro, let's go. You got to talk about this. Send us a DM. We do a lot of fun things on Instagram. We have a bit of a debate going on Twitter that you guys need to start voting for. Starburst, you know, there's this particular color that I call it strawberry. Some people call it pink. Corey disagrees with me, but Corey's wrong. So you guys should definitely vote on that. And then, guys, as always, it helps us out so much when you guys smash that like, you share this stream, get all of your Godzilla friends in the chat. Guys, we are so close to 3,000 subs. That is our end-of-the-year goal. We've done it before. I know we only have like 2.5 weeks left of December. But guys, especially with our Godzilla community, our Monarch Monstars community, we've hit 300 subs in a week because of you guys. So help us out. We can't do it without you, because in the end, we would like to hit 10,000 subs. So make sure you're spreading the word. TJ, my boy, says Apple dropped a Zilla drop an hour ago. Yeah, they dropping a lot, man. They're giving some stuff. And see, TJ already saying it's pink, Trey. I don't know. It's a close debate right now for strawberry. YouTube, everyone's pretty much saying strawberry, and we have like 20 votes there. So it's interesting. I'm curious to see what you guys think. But guys, let's not wait any longer. Let's go ahead and bring out our Monarch Monstars panel. Guys, you know the best co-host I could ever ask for, Super Bro Corey. How's it going, big fella?
Hey, buddy, I'm doing better, trying to, you know, I'm getting over all this coldness and sickness and stuff like that, but I'm happy to be here tonight, and I'm excited to see this this episode with you, and very disappointed in you that you had me backstage so I can defend myself. It's definitely the pink Starburst tray. Nobody would know what you're asking for. If you're like, hey, can I get the strawberry Starburst? I'd be like, all right, you want the red one?
Because I'm gonna tweak your little argument here. If you said pink, there's so many different like pink Starbursts now. You got to be specific, otherwise you're gonna get one from like, a tropical group.
Wrong.
Yes.
Wrong. The pink Starburst is always just the normal pink Starburst.
Incorrect, sir. I will fight this until the bitter end. You were just
you are wrong, buddy. This is wild. Like, do you say was it the yellow banana flavor? I have no clue what the yellow flavor is.
I say lemon. Yeah.
You say I can't have the lemon.
When you grab yellow taffy, do you call it yellow taffy or do you say banana? You know,
I say yellow taffy. And but also Trey, what do you call the orange one?
That one doesn't count.
Oh, it doesn't count.
No, because orange is orange.
Orange the color or orange the fruit?
Oh my God, Corey. As TJ says, it's pink Starburst. Nobody says strawberry. I'm telling you, bro. Nobody says strawberry, bro. Our YouTube poll says differently. Corey, already like 25 people have voted and it's like 85%.
Yeah. And those strawberry. Are people are crazy that I wouldn't want to associate with.
I hate to break it to you. Maybe Kojay can help us out. While the guys, obviously, we're giving you time to pull up your Apple TV. You got like 5 more minutes before we start this shindig. So let me bring in our boy Kojay. Kojay, are we wrong here?
Hey, I have no idea. Because I'm confused on the yellow. Because I do call it yellow, but is it lemon or banana? It feels more banana to me.
Yeah, like I think you just said the wrong flavor altogether, Trey.
I don't think so.
What do you think?
I do call the pink one pink because
attaboy.
Is it strawberry or is it rose?
Oh, that's a good point.
Had that flavor before, or is it just what Pepto Bismol should taste like? I don't know.
It doesn't even taste like strawberry. Does the pink
artificial strawberry? But it's still strawberry nonetheless.
Yeah, look at what TJ said. He's saying red is strawberry. I don't even think you got your colors right, buddy.
This is interesting.
I don't know.
Could I get the apple Starburst, please? nah, give me that green Starburst? One.
Don't be, Corey. You're being a juicy contradiction right here.
I don't know. I'm assuming, you know.
Replay through. Think... If you're watching this, make sure I have it in our community page. So on the Bat Channel, the YouTube page, you can click the community tab and vote on it. So like. I don't know. Is 85% of already 25 votes, you know, from our community wrong? It's a close race on Twitter where we have it. So
no, it's not close. Pink is winning.
It was 53-47%, Corey.
That doesn't matter. It's a win.
Jesus.
Strawberry all the way. I would not know what flavor to give you. Thank you, Oracle. Thank you.
But Red Hooded Outlaw, Corey says strawberry.
Bro, but like what? Like, look it up right now. Is the pink one actually flavored strawberry?
Yes.
What flavor is red? Is it cherry?
Yeah, I would have handed you a red. You asked me for a strawberry. I'm handing you a red.
You're just not a Starburst connoisseur, Corey. You know, maybe you just need to have some candy once in your life.
I just can't believe you're like, hey, yo, can I get some lime Skittles, please? Nah, you say, hey, I want them green Skittles.
No, man, I say grape. I say grape Skittles. I don't say purple Skittles.
Are Smarties?
I say purples.
Purples.
See, Corey, people in the chat are saying strawberry. Red is cherry. And like Oracle said pink. TJ said pink. Like, but I'm seeing a lot of people saying strawberry.
Y'all be asking for strawberry Starburst.
Wait, do they got a watermelon one?
They do have a, which is also another somewhat pink flavor, which is why I say you either say watermelon or strawberry, you know, otherwise you're gonna get one and be like, that's not the pink one, you know.
Nah, bro, they both pink.
I don't know what to do with you guys. You guys are just trouble.
Hey, bro, it's all artificial flavored. It doesn't actually taste like what it's supposed to taste like. So it's always going to be just the pink stuff, the red stuff, the orange stuff, the green stuff.
I don't know. I don't have to say. See, TJ saying grape is purple, but see, you gotta call it grape, because otherwise, in some of the Skittles package, you're gonna get like plum. You know, I'm just saying. You got to be specific about these things. Otherwise, you're going to take a bite and be like, that's not what I thought it was going to be. I don't know. Nine Lives, you did not help in this debate at all. You said, I would say peak or strawberry. Come on, Nine Lives. Mistress of Mayhem says pink. Okay, now here's one thing.
Good job, Mistress.
Where you guys are kind of breaking my argument a little bit, because this is a huge debate.
It's a fascinating discussion.
It's become a big, like, it's an argument in my office right now. Like, literally my whole floor of like 30 people are debating this very thing. And what we've come to notice is that majority of the guys say strawberry, and like the ladies in the office are all like, it's pink, you know? So you guys, Corey, KoJ, maybe
we understand ladies.
A little we understand the ladies. Now you understand. Nah, we're like, hey, yo, girl, let me get that pink Starburst.
It's like, oh, you're speaking my language.
Yeah, girl.
I never thought about that until you, Trey. Wow.
Well, you know, it's just one of those things, you know, guys. Oh, gosh. Well, I don't know. I don't even know. Guys, do you have any predictions for tonight's episode to get off this strawberry theme?
I want to see Godzilla that I want to see in the last episode.
Yeah.
I only saw the GIF. I didn't see the full. You said it was a spoiler, right? A little tease.
I mean, Apple TV is pretty much.
I just saw the GIF on Twitter with the thing I retweeted.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, Apple TV has pretty much let the secret out. There's definitely going to be some G-Man in this one. Yeah. Super Bro Corey, your thoughts?
Yeah, I'm just hoping we get a lot of the legacy cast.
Okay, you're just all about the legacy cast. You want to see more of them guys.
yeah, that's kind of what I hoping to see more of the legacy cast. I obviously want more Godzilla, more kaijus, but that's what I'm hoping for, bud.
If we see more of the legacy cast, we'll probably get more Godzilla, because the modern cast, do we have a name for them? I forgot. The modern one.
I haven't given the modern cast a name yet.
Okay. We can say modern, I guess. But the modern is closer to King of the Monsters, right? So maybe.
Yes, it's closer to King of Monsters. Yeah.
Much of Godzilla.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we have a $5 super chat here from Oracle's Clock Tower saying.
Hey.
Here is how you end the debate, Trey. What does Wonder Wife say?
Yeah, what does Wonder Wife? Is she home right now? Get her right now.
She's like knitting stuff. I'm not gonna
get lie. Her right
I
now.
I will just be
get her right now.
You. I will just tell
get
you.
Get her. No, get her right now. We don't believe you, big fella. Bro, we got a $5 super chat. You better get her right now. You put that back. You put that five chat super chat. Get back up. Sarah, what a wife! What a wife! I will leave this and call her if you better call her right now.
Do it. I will let you back in.
You better call her right now. You know what? I'm going to call her on the phone right now. You know,
I'll call her on the phone. No.
I'll call her on the phone. No, okay, you're going to call her?
Jesus. Can't believe. Here we are trying to start the watch party. Corey wants to.
No, I want to call Wonder Wife. I'm going to call Sarah.
Well, I'm calling her really right now, calling Wonder Wife.
No, I'm going to call her team right now. Let's see who she picks up.
Yep, I'm okay. Corey has started this whole debate.
No, put her on speakerphone, big fella. Put her on speakerphone.
Corey doesn't believe me. We got a $5 super chat going on where people's like, here is how you end the debate. Trey, what does Wonder Wife say? So I'm going to put you on speakerphone so I can ask you, what do you call that one Starburst? Because I already asked you the question. You know exactly what I'm talking about. What do you call that one Starburst? Hold on. I'm going to put you on speaker. Wonder Wife Sarah, what do you call the one Starburst?
Hey, there we go. Atta girl, Sarah.
Back to the show. Bye bye. Good God. Corey called the phone a friend, but it was my wife. See, I was going to be honest, Corey. I was going to say she said pink, but
hi, Sarah. I just want to say very good job of picking the pink one.
It's always the pink one.
See, it's always the pink one. Yep, I just want to let you know that I appreciate it.
And the yellow ones are gross.
And the yellow ones are gross. Yeah, we don't even know what the yellow ones flavored are. So thank you.
Lemon, how do you not know they're lemon?
Yep.
Love you, Corey.
Love you, Sarah. Bye.
Bye.
God.
I just had to let her know. I appreciate her.
I'll be the Jackie Chan. Like, I'm in the middle. I want no trouble.
I see. Thank you, Kojay. Hey, Kojay. I'm just going to say Kojay's with me.
Hey, Kojay, there's going to be trouble.
No.
Thank you so much for the $5 super chat and for embarrassing me on the stream. I appreciate it. This one is for you. Oh my gosh, you guys are too much. Yeah, see, TJ says, by the way, try out Compromise with you. They have products that both have strawberry as pink and watermelon as pink. They do. And you know, one of my coworkers, they used in their debate that, like, hey, Starburst calls them pink as well. Here's a bag that says all pink. But I have a counter argument to that because when I went to go see Godzilla Minus One in 4DX, when I sat, you know, went to the concession stand to grab me some popcorn, they had a bag that said Starburst strawberry. So they even switch it up every now and then. So I even have a pitch. You won't be able to read it off the phone, but
yeah, they probably fired that marketing manager and said, nah, dude, it's the pink one, and we're going to have to backtrack on this.
She is wrong. None. You guys are too much. My pleasure. Kojay,
good job, Oracle.
This is between y'all. You guys are too much. Well, hopefully you have Monarch Legacy of Monsters Episode 6 pulled up.
I thought we were talking about Starburst.
I have it set right on previously on Monarch Legacy of Monsters. Does everyone else have that? Let us know in the chat if you're ready. I'm assuming you guys on the panel, you're probably all trained now to just have it set on that.
Oh, yeah. I'm ready.
Sweet. Jeez, and the red one is sour cherry too. My God. It has been, I'm, no joke, it has seriously become a big debate.
I just want to let you know that Sarah's the greatest, and she's cooler than you.
I knew that already, Corey. She's my wife. You have to say that. Oh, gosh. Okay, so it looks like everyone is saying they're ready. Okay, let's see. Yep, Oracle saying ready. Red Hood Outlaw saying ready. Beyond the Night saying ready. TJ's already ready to go. Brogu giving the thumbs up. Trevor H ready. Ready. I just don't like black jelly beans, Brogu. I agree, Brogu.
Hey, nobody likes the black jelly beans.
No one likes the black jelly beans. Those are awful.
Kojay, do you like the black jelly beans?
I don't remember.
So the licorice, do you like black licorice?
There we go.
Depends. Sometimes it's so bitter and unbearable. Sometimes it's a little sweet and like, huh. Like, it goes into a root beer flavor.
Oh, okay.
Because there's different grades of black licorice. And I haven't eaten jelly beans in a long time. I don't do sweets. Oh, man.
Okay. But he did originally say that they were pink Starbursts.
I did.
Oh, God, Corey. It's going to be a theme throughout the thing. And now we're just going to get destroyed in the comments with it. But TJ trying to start a new debate saying we need a Lay's v. Doritos v. Ruffles debate. I agree personally with Red Hooded Outlaw on this one. There's no debate. Doritos. Cool Ranch Doritos, like, you just can't beat them. Like, Cool Ranch is the greatest Dorito, like, ever made. Especially when they did that, like, extra seasoning Dorito. Perfect.
Yeah, I think that's right. I think you have to give it to Doritos because, like, with the Ruffles or the Lay's, I'm probably going to be putting some, like, French onion dip on it or something like that.
It has to go with something, right? But with, like, Doritos, itself, you just eat by itself.
I was more of a Pringles guy.
Yeah, Pringles are good, though, too.
Pizza flavor.
Oh, pizza flavor all the way.
No, I hate black licorice. I think Doritos, Lay's, Doritos. Actually, Takis beats all of them.
Yes.
I tried the blue ones, and I wasn't impressed.
Takis Fuego?
Is that what it is? I don't know. I just saw like a crazy blue Takis chip, and I was like, Pringles, I'll try that. Chip
version of Takis. That is amazing.
Okay. I love that. Nine Live says, where has this show gone? I don't know. We're going to get right on it, though. Thanks for sticking with us, guys. Hopefully, you are ready to go. And let's just go ahead and get this started. I can't wait. I'm excited to see what they're going to do with this episode. But here we go. Coming down in 3, 2, 1. Play.
Oh, shit. There we go.
Taki sriracha ketchup? That just sounds nuts.
I like lemon Lay's with some extra squeezed lemon and Cholula.
Okay.
Or regular Lay's, it works that way too.
$19.54, here we go. Thank you so much, Oracle. Appreciate you always keeping up the chat. And here we go. It started. Rage, those flaming hot Doritos, though. Oh, they're just kicking us right into the intro, huh? Now, no little opener.
Oh, wow.
Interesting.
That is his little switch.
I think this is the first time they did that. Usually they start us with an opener.
Yeah. And some kind of.
Yeah, that's interesting. Thing. I think that means get ready for the effing show.
Yeah, it's probably going to be very action-packed.
I'm on it. I'm ready. You know, I had a friend who was all about your mom jokes or comebacks in like the most weirdest way. So in spirit of that, when I hear uranium, I think your mom's an anium. Sorry, bad joke. Thank you, Corey.
Well, that was funny, dude. I love it.
That's Frank Sinatra singing, Michael Bublé.
Love Frank Sinatra, old blue eyes.
I like Best Is Yet to Come. That's my jam.
so many of them, but I think I have to say my favorite, Fly Me to the Moon.
That's a good one. Yeah, oh, that's a good one. I want them to get together, not with the other dude. I like to think she's wearing turquoise for Gojira.
Gojira. Nope. That Martina ain't go.
Dang. For Gojira. Oh, that delayed laugh is awkward, though. Oh, a prejudice. Ah, one of the good ones. Oh, they didn't dance. You want to dance with me? Oh!
That come on sounded just like his father.
They're doing a slow cha-cha. Oh, he needs some more dancing training. Hey. Nah, they're not gonna kiss. Oh, they're finger dancing. He's like, I've been practicing. Oh, we're going up. Sorry, that was...
Nice. Dude blocked him.
Man, that sucks. Maybe that's why he wants to fight me. He's like, that one time.
That's why he hates Bill. He's just like, dude, seriously?
Yeah, it's that one time.
Wow, we knew there was going to be more friends.
So she's helping him and also May, right?
Yeah.
Or using. Sure.
It's an interesting theory, Restore Sniper Sky. Maybe, but based off that, Jonah was okay with people dying, and it seems like she's not. She just has a grudge against the Titans.
Yeah. Did they give her a digital tear in her right eye, I wonder? Oh.
Interesting. It'd be awesome, Craig, if it was Odo Island. Oh.
That's a tedious project. You gonna put all those together?
Yeah, yeah, the gamma rays, as we know, where Godzilla was drawing his energy. Yeah, Hollow Earth.
Doesn't have to push all the pushpins. So Central Asia, that makes sense for Kazakhstan.
It is not TJ. He said his name was Suzuki.
What if she's in trouble with the law from where she and her sister are at, and she had to bounce to protect her sister or something, and then she has the capabilities to erase that?
That's what it seems like, yeah.
Yeah. You know, like in Transformers 1. I don't like Billy. This guy looks like a bad guy in like a RoboCop movie, you know?
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Hey.
No. Finally.
I'm having a Star Wars moment. I have a bad feeling about this.
Oh boy.
Oh, flashback. I like how the past and the present are mirroring each other.
TJ's like, shut up, you wake him. It's like the orca. Yeah, from King of the Monsters, it's kind of similar, right? Kind of using like echolocation maybe to like awaken the Titans, similar.
I don't know if I agree with the homie there.
Oh. Made the wrong choice.
Yeah. All right, Billy, it was a little cool there for a second. because he knows this is also bad for their team. Dang. Billy wasn't blocking him because, you know, he's in trouble. Huh.
I love the shot.
That's a good shot. Hey. Yes. Is that a rejection kiss?
Did he swallow it? He did.
Wow.
Ooh.
That's cool.
Oh. Dang. That happened to me in Fortnite once. Oh, that's a shot. When you see that, they gotta show Godzilla now. Oh, I forget how big his arms are in this.
Oh.
He's like, fine, I'll take my nap elsewhere. Dang.
Wow.
Dang.
I saw him see me.
Told you that guy was sketchy at the party with the fake laugh. Now we know what happened, Monarch. Wow.
That's an interesting thought, TJ. Is he trying to force Godzilla's evolution? Not sure how he would think he could achieve that, but maybe it has something to do with Operation Hourglass. I don't know.
Dang.
Oh, God.
That was an episode.
Yes.
Oh, that was an episode.
That was a good, good episode. Wow. All right.
Wow.
Well, episode 6, there it is, Terrifying Miracles. We know episode 7 will be titled, Will the Real May Please Stand Up? So we're clearly going to find out what May is on the run from, who she's in trouble with, and why she felt like she had to leave. So I'm finally excited that we're going to get that answer next week. But it says, May finally faces her past. Duvall and Shaw follow traces of Godzilla and Hiroshi. Interesting. So in a way, if they would have just kept up with Shaw, they would probably be with their dad. Interesting.
Yeah, because he's following Godzilla. You want to follow your dad, follow Godzilla. That's what
yeah. I was saying. Yeah, people are saying betrayed again. Damn, lots of Godzilla. May probably has some financial issues. Well, it could be, you know, when they, you know, she uses her money that she supposedly has, whoever she's in trouble with finds her, you know, and that's how she faces her past finally. But very, very interesting episode. We got our legacy cast, Corey, Super Bro, you must be happy about that. What's your initial thoughts, my man?
Yeah, buddy, this was a really good episode. It, kind of brought us back to the original few episodes, how vibes and how they did, you know, how it was all over the place. You know, we were the legacy cast back to the modern cast and then back to the legacy cast and kind of hopping around in the time zone. And it's fun. It adds a little bit to the chaos of the show. And it's exciting when they do that. So overall, just a really good episode. And we kind of got an understanding of, you know, what the downfall of Monarch where it kind of happened and how it happened. So the next episode is going to be a damn good one as well, I believe.
Yeah, I agree. It's just, Corey, you kind of talked about it, and I know we'll break it down more in our discussion video this Saturday, but what do you think about the kind of the downfall of Monarch, how Keiko blames Shaw?
Well, you know, in a lot of ways, it is Lee Shaw's fault. You know, he shouldn't have left. He allowed his feelings to overcome the mission at hand. And this is the price that to be paid. Monarch is going to really change up how they do things. We're going to see how the kind of the modernization of Monarch. And they're in for the legacy cast is in for a shit show.
Yeah. Yeah. And it'll be interesting to see how they play off, you know, telling the government Monarch about Godzilla's survival. So, which we know pretty much that was going to happen. It Sarazawa in the 2014 Godzilla seems like he was never under the impression that Godzilla was dead out there. So they've known, you know.
You've worked for government before, and same here, Trey, and you know when there's leadership change as far as, you know, politicians or, you know, actual managers or department heads and such like that. It always rocks the boat, and it's always, you know, crazies. So it's, yeah, I'm jumping ship, bro.
Okay. Yeah. What general thoughts from you, my man, Kojay?
First off, there's a lot of Eminem in the news. Will the real May please stand up? And even in Fortnite, there's Eminem skins now. So I'm like, what's going on? There's a lot of Eminem references everywhere. But, dang. I see now that, Shaw, I feel like he's on more of a personal mission to fix, undo his wrong to her. To Keiko, because he kind of didn't kind of take her goal seriously. He screwed up Monarch over her for her, but it kind of ruined her dreams. So I could see, like, you know, maybe he's on this mission to making the wrong things right for her and for him, you know. So I'm seeing his goals a lot more, like he's more of a good guy.
Yeah.
If that makes sense.
Yeah.
Because I wasn't sure about Shaw with the modern cast.
Yeah, it definitely seems like there's something he's after, right? He thinks Hiroshi has the answers to it. But he's clearly not, you know, in the beginning, when Shaw first meets the kids, you kind of got the sense that maybe he cared about them, that he wanted to find Shaw for them in a way too, because he's their father and it's like his son, you know. But like, you kind of are starting to see his true colors a little bit. It's not so much the kids or Hiroshi. He's after something, you know. Mm-hmm. So hopefully we get some more of that as we see them chasing Godzilla now.
Well, the wall. Clearly it's interesting because you know, I think the loss of Keiko and everything like that, still has those feelings, and her love of Godzilla now wants, you know, it is kind of his mission, it seems like to me. That's how I kind of translated the what went down, you know, like he's trying to right a wrong in the past by, you know, helping Godzilla out today.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. Impressive, man. I loved how much Godzilla was in this episode. They weren't joking around. I'm kind of bummed that Apple TV kind of let it slip all over social media. It was on Instagram, it was on Twitter. Like, it would have been nice if they
I didn't see that.
Did you? Oh yeah, man. I just
saw the part where he's swimming in the legacy cast part, you know, when he just came
out. Oh yeah, yeah.
That's all I saw.
In some ways, though, you know, you can't blame them too much. They're trying to drive people to their show, and Godzilla is a great way to get people to watch.
Because we are primarily watching for Godzilla, too.
I mean, it is true. I mean, there's been a ton of people out there on Twitter saying, like, we need more monsters, we need more titans, which is partly why last episode was some of people's least favorite. Yes, it had the controversial stuff in it, but they were like, there was zero titans in it. It was just reused scenes that we've already seen. Like, I thought this show was going to be about monsters, and it was definitely more of a character development, which also explains some of the trailer. You know, they did a kind of like a inside the Monarch Legacy of Monsters show, and they did this whole thing where, like, they talked about all the monsters in the beginning of this 7-minute video. And then they're like, now, while we say we're talking a lot about monsters, this is a show about people. And they kind of drive into that little story a little bit to kind of be like, yeah, I mean, yes, but you're gonna get some of that character development as well. And we kind of talked about that in our last discussion video. This wasn't just going to be, you know, a simple, there's just monsters and that's the end of it. You know, it was going to be some character development, because what actor wants to do a show where they have really nothing to do in it, you know?
Yeah.
But how do you feel about, was this an improvement of last episode? Do you think, while last episode was great character development, do you think we got good character development in this, or was this episode clearly just about the Titans? Okay, you want to start?
No, I think this was a good episode. I feel like if somehow we could get here sooner in episode 5 with where we got in episode 6, I think that would be better. I think I see maybe some of the criticism, some of this is a little too drawn out. Then maybe if we pick up the pace and, I don't know, had this for an episode 5 or somehow got to this moment in the story for episode 5, that could have been better. Because, you know, we do get a lot of people in this, and I do see making a show called Monarch Legacy of People not being a selling point. But, you know, if it continues to build momentum from here on out where we are and try and top that momentum, I think mission accomplished. I just kind of wish we got here sooner, but I like all that we've gotten with the story and the character development, too.
Yeah, that's fair. That's absolutely fair. Super Bro, what do you think about that?
Yeah, man. I liked this episode quite a bit. I feel like it was a big step up from the previous episode. It actually, in some ways, kind of makes the last episode go down a little bit, you know, in my opinion. This was a much better episode. It flowed a lot better. It was fast paced. It was all over the place with the different cast. And it was, I was at the edge of my seat the entire time, kind of just enjoying it. And I had fun with this episode.
Yeah. And I like what TJ said here. By the way, did you notice the change in Kate's connection to Godzilla? Yeah. I mean, this is partly what I really love of what they've done with the Godzilla and the MONSTERVERSE, is that he's not just a giant dinosaur with spikes and can breathe atomic fire that just stomping around, destroying cities, you know, beating up monsters. He has that human connection to him. And I've stressed kind of my concerns with where they're kind of going with Godzilla, where he's becoming more of an action hero in the MONSTERVERSE rather than that human connection to him, which I always thought was very interesting. Like, they're kind of treating him more right now like just a fighting, like he's just a boxer, you know, he's just in there for the fight, and you're not really seeing the human element to him where he can have, I mean, I don't want to see Godzilla sign language like Kong can, but like there clearly is a human connection with him, as we saw with Sarazawa, just like Kaiju Crazy Craig said in the 2014 scene, even Brody, you know, in the 2014 scene, they had a moment, Godzilla had a moment in King of the Monsters, and we see his connection with Mothra. Like, he's able to play a character. He's able to have a story arc. You know, he's not just like show up to save the day and fight, you know? So I hope they utilize that more. And I'm glad that Monarch realizes that, because I think that was important that, you know, like TJ said, Godzilla saw Kate and he remembers her. You know, you kind of get that feeling that he kind of looks at her and he goes like, oh, I've seen you before, you know. I love that. It just shows the intelligence of this particular Titan, and it works for me with Godzilla. What I mean, this will be kind of our last point, but like, what did you guys think about that particular scene? As we'll discuss it more Saturday.
I liked it. I think it's a connection with him and Kate's grandma. So, because Godzilla probably could recognize, I'm guessing his sense of smell is great. So I think he recognizes that, you know, she's like an offspring or of the same type of person as Keiko, her grandma. So, and it looks like Keiko, because we saw a change in power. Our homies in the who are looking for him from Monarch in the helicopter, they all died. So we think. And then in the legacy cast, we have a new antagonist take over Monarch. So I'm wondering if our little bad guy, this guy died and another one took his place for, you know, the rest of the story going forward. So that's the case. There might be a story with the legacy cast where Keiko does something for Godzilla and he remembers that through her granddaughter. So that's why maybe he honed in, recognized her, then just like, I'll just walk, take a nap somewhere else in Grand Canyon or something.
He's just like, seriously, guys, like, I was just trying to relax.
Yeah, you know, he's like, I was getting my dirt bath, my mud bath here, man.
So I got in a fight with Egyptian Mushi, you know, Prime, you know, Muto Prime, and like, I just wanted, you know, my dorsal fin's broke now. I was just healing from it. Like, Jesus, leave me alone. Yeah.
On the right spot, you know, because lizards, I've had a lot of lizards or pets. When they sleep, they burrow underground. And they just, you know, sleep. Or alligators, they go at the bottom of the river or in there and they hibernate and they just freeze and stay hibernating until summer comes and all that. I can see Godzilla doing something similar in this area.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, it's cool that given some, I love the, you know, the scientific themes that they're kind of doing where it's kind of similar. It's similar to how an animal react, but there is that intelligence level too.
Yeah, he's very mature. You know, he's not just like, oh, snack, you know?
Yeah. Be. Super Bro, your thoughts about the Godzilla connection with Kate?
Yeah, I always enjoy seeing Godzilla connect with the human cast. You know, we're leading up to Godzilla King of the Monsters, right? So there was a lot of, you know, connections in King of the Monsters with, oh, gosh, I just spaced his name, Trey. The main guy of Monarch in King of the Monsters.
Oh, Sarazawa?
Yeah, Sarazawa. So, like, there's a lot of connections there when they're, you know, underneath the water or they're, you know, he's gone in to help Godzilla out as well. So, like, there's some really cool key connections there. So it's nice seeing that in this series as well. I hope we do dive in more into that human connection, human bond that Godzilla shares and kind of dive deeper into, you know, that and, you know, what his thoughts are. You know, maybe that's partly going to be the path of healing for Kate and everything like that as well. Overall, I do think that Legacy of Monsters needs to be careful with some of the kind of the repeat of stories in the sense of, you know, Lee Shaw and them separating again, because we all know that they're going to get back together again eventually. So it's like, well, we saw it once with them in Alaska and then now again here. So, but yeah, overall, I'm excited for next week. And yeah, it should be a good time.
Great, great points, Cray, all around. And as TJ wanted me to bring up, Keiko was right to blame Shaw. Trey, doesn't this answer the question of why in Kong Skull Island, why Monarch was strapped for cash? It certainly could. My original thought process was simply like when the trio, the legacy cast, if they were keeping secrets from the government, not telling them about all the Titans, it would kind of seem like the government was like spending money and kind of thinking, well, you guys haven't been giving us any information, so what good are you lately? You know, maybe there was Titans a long time ago, but nothing has showed up since, you know, we killed that one thing with Operation Lucky Dragon. But here we are kind of seeing like, yeah, they kind of pulled the plug on Shaw and Keiko and Bill Randa to the point where, you know, they are going to be strapped for cash. So it's a very good point. Hopefully they explain it a little bit more, though, because if anything, it looks like Keiko's thoughts were to kind of preserve and research and study Titans, and the military's, you know, focus is going to be to locate and destroy Titans. Mm-hmm. So it'll be interesting. It'll be really cool. I think it'd be smart of them to maybe, if they don't do it this season, hopefully we get a season two, and it would be cool to see this Monarch version be kind of military aggressive and see them like actually purge Titans, like just wiping out different Titan species.
I love that.
You know, it'd be an interesting, fascinating tale to kind of just see the government actually locating some of these things and wiping these creatures out to kind of show the inhumaneness of that too, you know, kind of the brutality of Monarch in some cases. I think that'd be an interesting story and kind of a similar story that we can kind of relate to through the human aspect of, like, you know, back then in the Old West when we were hunting buffalo so much, you know, just for their skin, you know, just for their coats, and then leaving the meat kind of thing. You know, there's kind of that natural thing that kind of pulls us apart. It's kind of interesting.
Or Trey, like after the Jaws movie when we went out and droves to kill sharks.
A whole bunch of sharks, people feared sharks back then after Jaws. That's a wonderful, that's a great point, Corey. Mm-hmm. It would be a natural reaction to, I mean, we even kind of see the reaction now with, you know, Japan with you know, the officers at the ball, they were like, oh, she's Japanese, like, ooh, like that's scandalous. You know, there's just that natural reaction to when you have a certain hatred or kind of ignorance towards something, you're just immediately, you know, some people in the society are immediately cut off and just like, no, this is bad, and they want to destroy it. So it's a very interesting story I think they could tell there. Great point, TJ, all around. That's why I hate the goofball who dropped the oxygen destroyer. Yeah. they thought that would work in King of the Monsters. I just thought it was a very cool Easter egg for us Godzilla fans. Well, Trey, I already know that we are two. Meaning, well, Trey, I already know that we are two. What do you mean by that, TJ? Like season two? Is that what we're talking about? I don't know. And of course, Batman. Not even going to show his comment. you know, I just think this episode, more on the right track for what I think the general audience wants, with, you know, more Titans, more Godzilla. I think we're going to continue to get some, especially as Lee Shaw and Duvall are chasing Godzilla, and Hiroshi's maybe leading Godzilla somewhere. I don't know. It'll be an interesting show for sure. So guys, make sure, if you haven't already, I will be setting up our show for episode 6 discussion this Saturday at 2 p.m. Eastern, as always. So make sure you guys set your reminders when that comes up. And smash that like, share, sweet, subscribe if you haven't already, and hit that notification bell. Kojay, my man, what do you got coming up?
Just more of my games, gameplays, game streams, Snarka Fighters. That's all it. I have a bigger project that's coming later. But I am excited to do the project, the Super Sentai Watch Party, with you guys. And we're doing that. That should probably go live for you, for everybody, or premiere like sometime next week. But we'll see. I'm excited for that. Original Power Rangers. We're all going to watch it. And you guys are invited. Stay tuned for, like, I'm really bad at promoting this right now. So I'll make a trailer for it, and then the episodes will drop, and then we'll all have fun. It's a watch party. It'll cost maybe $25 or $6, but I'll explain that later. It's going to be fun.
Cool. I'm so excited for that, dude.
I'm excited for it too.
That's gonna be a good time. Excited. Just some of the things that Kojay has showed us behind the scenes, where it's just, it's like you're geeking out. You kind of feel like you can't, like, oh, this is so cool.
And it kind of correlates with this, because there's a huge Godzilla element with Super Sentai.
Yeah.
If y'all don't know.
Absolutely. So TJ says season 2, it's happening. It's apparently on the app, it's just not announced. Oh, I did not know that. I'll have to look to see where they say that. That's great news, though. If it is a done deal, I think there should be. Season two would be awesome. So that makes me happy. And everyone just saying hi to Bat Dan. Well, guys, make sure to subscribe to my boy Koj and hit that notification bell, because we'll be doing some fun stuff over there. I can't wait for this Super Sentai. It's just going to be a damn good time, as always, with my man Koj. And then, as always, don't forget Saturday, episode 6. We might be joining Retro. I don't know if we'll have time yet. We'll figure it out, though. We also will be doing, I know a lot of people have been asking about our Godzilla Minus One discussion with everyone on Monarch. We will be setting that up. I'm just trying to ask everyone when, you know, they're free and available next week to do a big show about it, to talk about how well it's doing at the box office, too. It's incredible, and it's actually starting to win awards now. So super happy to hear Godzilla Minus One is doing well. But, guys, I just wanted to say thank you so much for hanging out with us today. Replay crew, you guys can comment all the way through what you guys think about different scenes and episodes. We love to hear from you guys, and we'll be happy to comment. But guys, thank you so much for hanging out with us. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe if you haven't already, and hit that notification bell so you never miss an episode. I am your host, Trey, with Super Bro Corey and my boy, Koj. And don't forget to tune in weekly, same bat time.
Same bat channel.
You guys already know. And now, as always, a special message from our sponsors, just reminding you to be safe out there in a world full of titans. TPP, ladies and gentlemen.
Have good a night, everyone.
And now, a special message brought to you by the Titan Preparedness Plan.
With the recent spike in Titan sightings circulating on social media, proactive preparation for a Titan emergence event is crucial. A single towering force of nature has the potential to forever alter the lives of millions. It is our mission to help you prepare for that force. The Titan Preparedness Plan is your guide to staying safe in the face of monsters. These are the three steps you need to know. 1. Know before you go. Identify the location of your nearest Titan shelter and practice navigating a Titan evacuation route with your family on a weekly basis. 2. Run and take cover. In the case of a Titan emergence, calmly sprint to the nearest Titan shelter. If your designated shelter is inaccessible or at capacity, seek the basement or lowest floor of a nearby building. 3. Stay informed. Follow any further instruction from local authorities and stay informed using your mobile device, television, or radio. We can't stop a Titan emergence, but we can safeguard our lives. Join us in building a safer, more resilient community. We are here to protect you.